Oxford had, I was back in a place with graduate students as opposed to Princeton, which had only postdoctoral fellows and so on. And so the life in Oxford from then onwards was there was substantial involvement with the research students that I had, of, you know, many of whom were great success. I had a lot of good students at various, although ups and downs. I mean, there were fallow periods and fruitful periods. But so the involvement with the research students there played a bigger role. And I think later on, you know, when I looked back on it, I realized that, you know, that was a sort of, that would never have happened if I'd been in Princeton. I would never have had research students. Well, not quite. Well, that's not quite true. I mean, George Lustig was a kind of research student of mine in Princeton. You know, he came over, you know, as a young Romanian without a degree, and so he came to Princeton. He was not sure, he may have been my assistant formally at some stage, and he was doing a degree technically at Princeton University under Bill Browder, because institutes didn't give degrees. So, you know, but effectively he was working with me, and he did his thesis with me at the institute, but the university nominally gave him his PhD. But that was rather an exception. So, except for that, there weren't really PhD students. And by being in Oxford over a long period of time, I acquired, you know, a substantial number of students, and probably did through that, influencing students and with what they did, you know, had more success than I would have done if I'd stayed on an institute for another, you know, 10 or 15 years. So I think it worked out well. Although I hadn't probably thought it all through that way, I came back.
Yeah.